In our lab, we wanted to interrogate whether HER3 is required in HER2 amplified cancers, or if eventually cancer cells can find a way to grow and survive independently of HER3. The current hypothesis in the field is that HER3 is required for the growth of HER2 amplified cancer cells. This means that HER2 amplified cancer cells need HER3 expression to grow and survive. I had some preliminary data that I was generating in the lab, some small evidence here and there in small experiments in vitro that was telling me that cancer cells in the absence of HER3 were still able to form tumors. To test this hypothesis, we really had to go in vivo and go into mice. Interrogating these HER2 amplified human cells in mice will directly give us an idea of the tumorigenicity of these cells. In our case, we chose immunocompromised mice, known as NEWT mice. That means that the immune system of the mouse has been compromised, so will not react against the human cancer cells that we are going to inject into the mouse. There are different approaches to target HER3 and its activity. Target the expression of HER3 by using shRNA, short herpin RNA, or siRNA, a small interfering RNA, or the CRISPR-Cas9 technology, or targeting the activity of the protein by using an inhibitor. shRNA and siRNA, both techniques allow you to reduce the expression of a protein by targeting the messenger RNA of the protein. In both cases, you are reducing the level of expression, you are not completely eliminating the expression of the protein. Ideally, we would have used an inhibitor for HER3, but currently there are not inhibitors available. Right now, HER3 remains undruggable. Therefore, we went with CRISPR. And the reason for that is that this approach allows you to eliminate completely the expression of the protein. We wanted to go in vivo. We wanted to interrogate this question in mice, and having a complete knockout, a genetically altered cell line not expressing HER3, will allow us to study the absence of HER3 in the cells in vivo. The predicted outcome is that those cells were not going to form tumors. And indeed, they didn't. Initially, for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, there were no tumors there. And we kept monitoring those mice and waiting and waiting. And suddenly, like 4 months and a half, we started to see a small bump. And that was the beginning of a tumor. Not only in one mouse, actually, 2/3 of the mice developed tumors after 5-6 months. The scientific literature indicates that HER3 is essential for the growth of these cells. But what we did in this experiment is to push out the limit and monitor the tumor growth of these mice for longer than was done before. And therefore, we managed to see that actually these cells eventually are able to adapt to the lack of HER3.